Hello, and welcome to Eaton's Power Systems Experience Center in Houston, Texas. In this video, I'm going to talk about line installation and protective equipment, or as Eaton terms it, LIPE. This includes cable accessories, surge arresters, fuses, switches, cutouts, or any other physical hardware we might see up on the utility pole or in the underground distribution system. Specifically, we will take a deep dive into the cable accessories portion of LIPE and see how it plays a crucial role in the reliable distribution of power. Cable accessories encompasses medium voltage cable connectors, such as T-bodies, elbows, splices, and junctions, typically rated for 15, 25, or 35 kV. So, why are cable accessories so important to medium voltage distribution systems? They might not be the most glamorous part of the utility power grid, but they are critical to ensuring reliable distribution of power. When we consider how power is delivered, we can break the utility grid into several sections. We have the point of generation, where the power is physically created. From there, it is delivered to the transmission and sub-transmission stages, where the voltage is stepped up to voltage levels exceeding 33 kV. This ensures efficient delivery of power across long distances. It then reaches the distribution stage, where the voltage is stepped down from the transmission voltage level to a voltage level suitable to be distributed to the end customer. Typically, this falls in the voltage range of 1 kV to 38 kV. This is where we find ourselves when we specifically look at cable accessories. These components allow us to connect one cable to another, repair that cable, physically make a connection to the power equipment, or add additional underground distribution accessories to our system. Before we dive too deep into the actual components, it's important we understand a bit of industry terminology. If we open a piece of equipment, such as a transformer or switchgear lineup, and see exposed bus bars or conductors, this piece of equipment would be deemed live front. This means it directly exposes anyone in contact with that equipment to live, energized parts. It's important that proper precautions be taken when dealing with live front equipment, and only by qualified personnel, as arc flash hazard concerns can be present in this situation. When we mention dead front, the equipment internals would not be exposed, and use an insulated cable accessory to connect the medium voltage cable to the transformer. This insulated connector to the equipment terminal and lack of exposed parts would make it a dead front application. Obviously, the dead front application is much safer for anyone qualified to be inspecting or operating the equipment. Similar to the terminology just discussed, it's important we understand the difference between loadbreak and deadbreak devices. Loadbreak devices allow an operator to make or break a connection while the equipment is energized and under load. Conversely, if a piece of equipment or application is deemed deadbreak, the equipment must first be de-energized for any operation on that equipment. Often, deadbreak applications require the operator to interface with exposed and possible live parts. This is why it is crucial the equipment be de-energized in any deadbreak application, unless noted otherwise. Now that we have a firm understanding of those four key terms, we will take a look at the first cable accessory, the 200 amp loadbreak elbow. To physically make conductors to equipment in applications not exceeding 200 amps, we often choose a 200 amp rated load break elbow. Since these are load break rated devices, we do not need to de-energize the equipment to make or break the circuit. In 15 kV and 25 kV rated applications, the elbow will seat onto the bushing well insert, which is seated onto the bushing well. The bushing well is the only component of the three that is mechanically secured to the equipment. The bushing well insert and the bushing well allows the elbow to interface and connect to the equipment, completing the circuit. It is not much different than a simple plug-in receptacle application you might find in your home. All three of these components and all of Eaton's molded rubber products are made from EPDM rubber. On a Loadbreak elbow, there is a semiconductive outer jacket, a semiconductive insert, and the insulation. This semiconductive rubber is how the Deadfront application is maintained when the elbow is in use. On all Loadbreak elbows, the conductor will connect via a copper top compression connector that interfaces with the probe. Conventional theory tells us that when we try to break contact between two pieces of equipment carrying current, we will have an arcing of current across the gap as we disconnect that equipment. So how do we mitigate this arcing between the equipment? In Eaton's 200 amp Loadbreak elbows, we've included an arc follower on the probe and an arc snuffer on the bushing insert. This mechanism extinguishes any arc across the equipment and the elbow as the circuit is being disconnected, maintaining our load break capability. Jumping up to 600 amp ready cable accessories requires us to de-energize the equipment before we can make or break a circuit, hence the dead break terminology that we discussed earlier. This time, instead of an elbow-shaped device, the device is shaped like a T, generally denoted in the industry as a T-body. They are bigger than their 200 amp load break counterparts and more robust, and allow the option to connect an additional cable accessory, such as an elbow arrester, to the other end of the T-body. If we wanted to, we could even interface a 200 amp load break elbow onto one end of the T-body. Much like its load break counterpart, the dead break T-body is made of an outer semiconductive jacket, inner semiconductive insert, and the insulation. Once again, this construction allows it to maintain that dead front application. It is important to note that in the 35 kV voltage class, the bushing well and the bushing well insert become a one-piece design. So, how do we know which connector to choose? Selecting the right connector is dictated by a few key things. First, we need to know if this is a load break or a dead break switching application, the applicable voltage range, and if the application is 200 amps or 600 amps. Remember that most load break applications will fall into the 200 amp rated category, while 600 amp applications will be dead break. To achieve a 900 amp dead break rated application, additional equipment considerations must be taken. We must also understand the parameters of the cable that is going to be used. We will want to confirm cable conductor size, type, and insulation diameter. Because medium voltage cable is made of multiple layers, the diameter of the cable may vary for the same ampacity rating. In addition, we must understand the application the cable accessory will be utilized in, as this will dictate the selection of accessories, such as capacitive test points and integral jacket seals. Capacitive test points allow an operator to verify if a circuit is energized or not. Jacket seals allow the connectors to be used in an application that might face submersion or moisture ingress, such as a downtown utility vault. Now, you're probably wondering, there's many different products on the market. How do I know which manufacturers are compatible with each other? All load break connectors in compliance with IEEE standard 386 are compatible with other manufacturers' connectors within the same interface category. Per the chart, these are the different combination of manufacturers that are interchangeable with one another. Note that for 35 kV, small interface and large interface designs are not interchangeable if they are not the same interface size. As we mentioned before, cable accessories encompasses more than just load break elbows and dead break T-bodies. It includes splices, which allow us to repair a cable or mate two or more sections of cable together. It includes fused load break elbows and elbow arresters. A utility may have an application for an elbow arrester where they can add an elbow arrester to a normally open point on a transformer and dramatically improve the surge protection. It also includes junctions, such as those we might find in a vault application, or feed-throughs, which we might find in a loop feed transformer configuration. Now, I'm going to throw you a curveball here. Up to this point, we have only mentioned the 600 amp connectors in a dead break rated application. What if I told you it was possible to have a 600 amp load break application? With Eaton's Cleer load break switching technology, it's possible. And today, Eaton is the only manufacturer on the market to offer this. The advantages of this system are endless. Mainly, it does not require equipment upstream, such as a switchgear lineup, to disconnect and de-energize the equipment where our connectors land. It decreases downtime in the field, it's safer to operate, and provides greater opportunities for uninterrupted power during sectionalizing and maintenance. Most importantly, this product sets itself apart in the market because it provides a means of a visible break to the operator, allowing them to confirm that the circuit is indeed open. In the field, it is safer and often a requirement to have this visible break. It also reduces the wear and tear on bulky 600 amp cables and subsequently parking them during switching operations. This clear disconnecting means changes the way utilities approach 600 amp switching applications. Real world applications for this include Model 6 and Model 9 switchgear applications, sectionalizing points, and bypassing switches for reclosers and regulators. Clearly, Eaton's cable accessories provide the solutions utilities need to maintain reliable and efficient underground distribution of power to their customers. If you would like to learn more about Eaton's cable accessory products, contact us or your local Eaton sales representative to schedule a visit to one of Eaton's Power System Experience Centers today.